One of the favorite books in the Bible for me is a very short one called Philemon. And Philemon is basically a slave owner of a guy called Onesimus. And Paul is writing to Philemon to tell him that he's discovered and come across Onesimus. Basically, the story is that Onesimus must have done something wrong. And he ran away from his slave. And he ended up being miles and miles away in a place called Rome. And he got to Rome, and there he found Paul in prison. Now, how he knew Paul was in prison, I don't know. Maybe Onesimus himself got in trouble, we don't know. But the problem is this, that he goes there, and he meets the Apostle Paul. And so Paul shares the good news about Jesus Christ, how he died and rose again to save saviors like sinners like him. And then he realizes that he too needs to become a Christian. And so Onesimus, in a short period of the time, became a Christian. And so the letter of Philemon is basically Paul saying, I've got Onesimus with me, and you need to come. I'm going to send them back to you, but I'm going to send them back with terms and conditions. Basically, he says to them, Philemon, I don't want you to take Onesimus back as a slave anymore. I want you to take him back as a brother in Christ. And so we can imagine the dynamics of the relationship between the slave and the master has now changed. There's a whole bunch of rules and regulations for slaves in the New Testament, and there's a whole bunch of regulations and rules for slave owners in New Testament times. So we can imagine the dynamics changing. But imagine how Onesimus must have felt as he's travelling home. He's travelling back to Philemon. And he's got this letter in his hand from Paul. Imagine what's going through his mind, thinking, wow, is Philemon going to treat me badly? Is he going to sell me in the marketplace? And we can imagine how Philemon must have felt when Onesimus appeared on the door, thinking, wow, is this guy for real? He's really my brother in Christ. And so the letter of Philemon is really an appeal, if you want, a love letter from Paul to Philemon, telling him about Onesimus. But one of the main lessons in here is that Paul says the reason that he may have left is that you may have him back for good as a brother. It kind of reminds me of the story of Joseph. Remember, he gets taken away, sold into captivity in Egypt. And his brothers eventually find out, and they're like panicking, oh no, they're going to find out who we are. And Joseph says, no, guys. The reason you're here is because God had planned that for you to be here. And so maybe in a way, Onesimus running away was all part of God's plan to bring him back to strengthen the church in Philemon's house, and also the church in Colossae as a whole. So the reason I'm telling you that is very simple. Sometimes we don't understand God's plans. Sometimes we don't understand God's ways. But if we trust that God has a plan for us, and we trust that he knows our plans better than us, then maybe sometimes when difficulties come our way, or we end up going one place to another place, maybe it's because that's what God has planned for us in the first place. He's got something bigger and better for us. So may God bless you. Thank you for watching. Have a great day.